This week, my parents visited to help me out. We started on the simple straight wall by the basement stairs. The 9-foot studs go in pretty easy and they hold themselves level without any bracing, so it's a good place to start. We added strap on the outside at both midway and top of the studs. Here's a close-up from my second camera. We decided that we still needed to brace these straight walls if we wanted to get the lath to lay flat. So we fastened the braces to the studs and we put stakes in the ground, and then we adjust for plumb and screw the brace to the stake to hold it in place at the right angle. Then we got to lathing the inside of the wall, since the shotcrete will come from the outside. You can see here one of the studs fell out of plumb, but we restaked it before adding lath. Now that my parents had the idea down, we moved on to the 26-foot studs for the tower. We decided to break for lunch, but first we had to set up my parents' pop-up camper. We put it on the top of the hill where we'd have a great view and nice cool breezes. After lunch, we got back to the tower. The taller studs were catching the wind, and we found it was easier to hold them plumb with a second person steadying at a point higher up. Then we got onto the easier 9-foot studs on the south side of the tower. Since the strap can't hold the second direction with these curved walls, we ended up cross-bracing to ensure plumb in both directions before strapping. Then my mother and I worked on lath for the tower while my father got to drilling the many holes we would need to tie the rebar into the footing. The 5 sections of scaffold came in handy, even if I never did need to stack them all as one 26-foot tower. Instead, I felt like even the tallest studs were stiff enough that I only needed to apply strapping that I could reach with the second scaffold. On the second day, the mission was to move the bracing to the inside of the studs where they could help resist the forces of the shotcrete. We got the scaffold out of the way, and we started to brace the tower first. Each wood brace was cut at the end to fit nicely up against the inside of the tower, and then screwed through the lath into the steel studs with a long self-tapping metal screw. Then the other end was screwed to a well-placed stake, and then we cross-braced. After the inner bracing is in place, we can remove the outer bracing and reuse that elsewhere. It's hard to see from this angle, but now we're bracing the inside of the far room. My father started working on fixing my mistake with the footing dimensions under the closet. We needed to extend it by a couple feet. Meanwhile, my mother and I got to working on the curved east wall. We were short on studs and thought we could get away with bracing only the studs that were not already plumb. After adding forms to extend the footing and drilling in rebar, my father used some concrete blocks as temporary supports for the steel track. Meanwhile, my mother and I were getting very frustrated and finding it impossible to get good flat metal lath without properly bracing the outside of the studs. She did a supply run to get the wood we would need to brace things properly. On the third day, we started by finishing the bracing on the curved wall and then started putting up the last few studs on the closet. Again, we plumb braced and cross braced in prep for strap and lath. However, we couldn't get the last stud in because phase 1 bracing from the curved wall was in the way. We switched back to finishing lath on that curved wall. You can see my father still faithfully working on drilling the holes for the rebar in the background. That is a lot of bending over. The fourth day, the first camera malfunctioned due to bad batteries, and we didn't get any footage. But I got this from the second camera. Mostly we spent the day moving bracing from the first to final position, and did other minor jobs that needed doing. My father kept on going with his drilling and then cutting and placing rebar. The fifth day, and it was time to get back to strapping and lathing the closet. For such a small place, it took a relatively long time because we had to do lots of bends in the lath, and it was just hard to work in that space. With the closet done, we realized that it was time to do a happy dance and then go to lunch. After lunch, my father worked on my skid steer while my mother and I worked on the inner bracing for the closet. Here we're working on sewing the lath together with little pieces of wire. There's a lot of sewing to do, so we were glad when the reinforcements arrived. The kids helped for a while, but Sherry and my mother got the lion's share done. Meanwhile, my father and I were working on the number 5 rebar and forms for the concrete columns. Finally, we had a serious cleanup session ahead of the predicted weekend storms. Next week, we should be working on rebar, electrical, and maybe connecting the earth tubes to the tower.